Hello and welcome to GeForce. I'm Julian, here with VJ, and there is a lot on display here at CES, and that pun is intended because there's a ton of cool G-Sync tech that Nvidia is showing off. First off, we're gonna look at the 360Hz monitors. Tell me about these.
360Hz monitors are a new G-Sync category for esports displays. And 360 is 6 times faster than a 60Hz monitor, and it significantly improves a competitive gamer's gameplay.
So let's go into specifics here. We've got 3 different demonstrations showing off here at CES. What does each one of these show that 360Hz does?
At a top level, we did some research with competitive gamers, and we had them play on 60Hz, and then we had them play on 360Hz, and their flick shot improvement was 37%, so absolutely gigantic improvement. And like you mentioned, there's 3 demos and 3 sort of components we talk about. The first is improved comprehension. So if you look at any game that has a lot of motion, like Dota 2, at 360Hz, the animations are incredibly smooth. And so you can read the text and you can track the characters for better target acquisition and that kill shot. The second thing is something we call precision aiming and target acquisition. So as you're moving in a game, you want the clearest motion possible. You don't want any ghosting, you don't want any tearing, and you want smooth animation. So as you're tracking a target, you can tell it's a target, not the background. The third thing is instant reaction times. With a 360Hz display, your screen is updated every 2.8 milliseconds. At 60Hz, it's 16 milliseconds. And so you can acquire a target much sooner because your system latency is so much lower.
Yeah, I was playing the Dust 2 map, opping, and I went from hitting nothing to 80 to 90% of the shots. But for somebody who has a 240Hz monitor, what kind of difference will 360Hz make?
Yeah, great question. We had our research team look into that. So with pro players, going from 60 to 240, they saw a 33% improvement. And like I mentioned, from 60 to 360, they saw 37. So 4%. 4% doesn't sound so big. In the 2016 Summer Olympics, the difference between gold and silver for the 100 meter and 200 meter dashes, men and women, 1%. So when you tell a pro, I'll give you a 4% improvement, they get excited.
Yeah, that's a huge difference. We also are showing off mini LED monitors. Tell me more about these.
So mini LED, we first introduced last year with 576 local dimming zones and 1,000 nits peak brightness. What we're doing this year is we've doubled the number of zones to 1,152. And so you get even deeper blacks, even brighter brights, and we've increased the peak brightness to 1,400 nits. When you combine that with the latest RTX games, the level of realism and immersion you get, it's absolutely amazing.
And then, of course, there's the big centerpiece, LG OLED that are G-Sync compatible. Tell me about these amazing TVs.
They're big. They're OLED, so they give you extremely black blacks, very bright brights. Unlike other TVs that you might game on, these ones are highly responsive. So it feels like you're playing on a desktop G-Sync monitor, but what you're playing on is a gigantic TV.
You know, when we spoke a year ago and the G-Sync compatible program was announced, there were a total of 12 monitors out of 400 you had tested. Now, right at the start of the year, 12 OLED TVs are certified. Is the amount of monitors that are G-Sync compatible just accelerating?
It is increasing. Today at CES, we have 90 G-Sync compatible monitors. So we're working with the ecosystem every day to bring better quality displays to the gamer.
Well, we hope you guys enjoyed this rundown of all the amazing monitor tech that Nvidia is showing off here at CES 2020. Stay tuned for more coverage from CES, and I'll see you next time.